Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. So today we're going to talk about module context in Svelte. What is module context? Well, we shall take a look at examples and we'll figure that out along the way. So let's take a look at examples. So here I have my app and I have a component called map. This is a very contrived example. I tried to come out a very convincing example, but I failed. So this is a very, very contrived example, but it serves its purpose well, I believe, to explain this concept for you. Okay, so bear with me with like unreasonable variables over here. So I have two components. I have one component, but use it twice. I have two maps over here, and I have inputs. Okay, so over the map component, I have a div. So this is one map component. It says it has some it imports some stores, and it has some buttons that you can click, right? Set me and who set. So the store itself, because we want to share it across components, as in it does not have to be across like component A and component B, it's more of like across all the map components instance, then I probably would have to create this store somewhere else outside the components and to be able to use it and import it over here, right? Because if you try to create a store variable over here, like I try to say import writable from Svelte store and try to create a store from here, what I end up creating is this store is actually like a state within this component. So if I have multiple map component, I will have multiple store created, and that's not what I want. I want to be able to share across all the map components that is going to be created. So what I do is that I create a new file, external file, and create and store here. So every time when I import here, when I create a new map component where it imports from this store, they're actually importing from the same store, right? It's the same store instance. So there's only one instance. Sometimes we call this a singleton because it's just single one ton, right? So if it's a singleton one store instance, then I would have to move it out into one separate file and import it from here, right? So here I have a map store file. I create this store instance and I import it into the map component. Okay, so this is the map store, and I also use this store over here in the app component, right? So here in app component, I render inputs that I can change, and I can update the value of the store from the outside, right? So that's so this store is like external, where I can import from across multiple files, but and use it and update it there. Right, so here I have some problem over here. I wouldn't say a problem, but I have some questions over here where I would think like, is there a better way of writing this? Is that the map store itself, we kind of agreed that I can't create this map store within this map component because it will end up become like a state for this component. I want it to be a singleton. I want one instance across all components. But this map store itself is it's very coupled or related to this map component, right? So import it from separate files feels like they are two separate things. So that is something that I doesn't really like. So this is something that we're gonna take a look and how we can fix it later, right? So now take a look at another file. Another file I have is called a map data. So this is also an external file where I have variables that I exported. So this is again like a singleton, right? This is a module. Oh, no matter how many people import this module, there's only one instance of this module. So there will be only one instance of the current map. And I also expose functions to update this current map. So what this current map does is that, no, it's contrived, but what it tries to do is that it will take in a current map. For now, this current map is like a div that wraps around each of the map, right? It takes in this div. If there's something that's set as a current one, I will set the border to none. And then, so this is kind of like reset the previous current map. And now I'm going to update my current map and also set a border so that you can see that it's being set. This is the current map. This is the value of the current maps right now. So fair enough. So here in my map, I have two buttons. When I click set me is to set call set current map, the current div, so that you can see that it has a border so that visually you know that I have updated the value. You want to actually know whether the value, then I have another button called who set that will console out current map. So this is what we exported. So you may not know this. This may feel like a variable that you, to you that does it gonna be updated, but it will, right? It will, because anything that is being imported is actually a live binding. Anytime when you try to out the variable value over here like this, this variable actually will be updated live. This is not some magic from Svelte. This is actually the specs from JavaScript. Okay, so if you import something, if this is a variable, like you do export let something or export const something, this variable itself, export const you can't change because it's a constant, right? Export let something, this variable itself, if you update it from anywhere, I'm not sure about anywhere, but if you update it from a file like here, this variable value actually will change, right? This will actually change. Let's see. So let's try run something, right? So here I call set me. So this has a border, and I call who set. You will see that in the console. So I will print out the current set value. So I click who set. You'll see this div. If I hover over it, you'll see which one is being turned on, right? So if I click on this button, it's still showing the same current map. If I try to change this set me. Now, if I click who set, you'll see that now it's print out this div instead. This button is the same thing, right? So now I can change my div and I can print out who is being set. That's great. So what is this context, a module context thing? How does this help me improve my code? This situation over here. Map data, again, like map store, I want to say is that this current map and this set's current map is very, very tight to this component itself, right? If it's possible, you want to actually write them in the same file. But unfortunately, you can't, right? Because if you try and declare current map in this map.svelte, if you say let's current map, then this variables itself over here will become a state of this component, which is not what you want. You want to share this variable across all the maps instance, right? As you see just now, when I try to click who sets across, this current map is the same value across and it's being updated with the same function to update all across them, right? So this is something that you wouldn't want to put it in the same, that you can't put it in the same file. But with module context, we're going to show you that actually you can. There's actually ways to do that. So you remember the time when I say that a file, you can only have one script tag? Well, I kind of actually lied a bit because we haven't learned about module context. Module context is actually telling us that, you can have another tag, another script tag. You can have another script tag. But this time around, yes, you can only have one script tag, but this script tag, we're going to add module context, which is, I'm going to say context is module. When I do this, you see the errors is gone. So this script tag and this script tag is different. So take a look at the errors, right? Let me remove this and take a look at errors. It says one component have only have one instance level script element. Instance level. So what Svelte called this script tag is actually an instance level of script tag, right? Instance level of the script element. So instance meaning for each of the instance you create like variables, right? So these variables are created for each instance, and therefore they are like a state within your component. Every time you have a new map component, you have a new div variable for this new map instance, right? But if you have a context module over here, this is a module level script tag. It's not instance level. So anything they find over here is on a module level. Do you hear what I'm trying to say? It's a module level. So meaning, previously I say that you have to import over here and you have a module singleton, you import from this module, everything for over here is defined like in this module, and everywhere you import is importing the same thing. This is actually creating a module inside your component, and anyone can import or do something like this. This is shared across, this only have one copy for one module. And therefore, what we're going to do is we can actually copy this two file, the two code from this file into this context module, and you can just refer it directly over here from your components. So that makes us have just write one component file and have code that can be on variables that are like instance level, are like states to your components, and as also variables that are like module level. So like this current map is module level, all the instance are importing from the same level. So if I come over here and define current map, this has conflict, but right now I'm gonna just comment this out. I'm gonna say this current map is actually just one copy of current map. And so what happens later on is that when you try to call set, you're actually updating one copy. All the instance, all the component, all the maps instance that you're gonna create, the two different components only have sharing one current map variable. Right here, I'm gonna copy this function as well, to set current map, to come over here and do it over here, right? So now your set current map and current map, actually, interestingly, they are available over here in your, everywhere in your code, right? So now what I'm trying to do now is that I'm gonna click set me, and I'm gonna open up the console again and take a look at whose is being set. Right, so now this variable is like a module level. It's not your state anymore. And if I click who set from here, it's pointing at this. Who set from here is still pointing the same variable, right? They are actually pointing the same variable. They are not like states in your component. If I try to set me over here, click who set, is this who set from outside, is still this this div, right? So they are actually being shared across all the components, just like how you would write it over here, one module and every component is important in the same module, right? So this is like module level variables, functions, and everything that you can think of. So before I go ahead and talk about more, you may have questions like how would this be different from other states? Like, yes, I get what you're trying to say, but why is this different, right? How does Svelte create this like module instance for me? And actually there's no magic to this, right? So you know, like every Svelte file, like the file that ends with .svelte, is going to be compiled down into JavaScript, right? And you import this Svelte component, you're actually importing the file, you're importing this file, and it export default the component itself, right? So this is actually a module that you're importing, right? It's like a .svelte file, it's actually a module and you're importing. And all this code over here, if you open up the JS code, you realize that all of these are being pasted over. That's fine. It's actually on the module level, right over here. So this is so-called module level. It's in this JavaScript module level. So if you have other things like states, like for the div, they are actually defined inside this function called instance. So this instance function is being called every time when you have a new map instance component being created, right? So this variable, every time when you have new map components, this new instance function being created, this new variable is being created and being used. But variables or functions over here, like current map and set current map, are defined at a module level. They are pasted, like they are copied over at the module level. So actually, Svelte does not do any magic over here. Anything that you write on a context module over here will be pasted over here. No magic over here at all. And no reactivity at all. You can't really expect that you change this variable over here and get everything to be updated. You still need like a store. You still treat this like like a shortcut of not having to write a separate module file to declare them, just paste everything in here. And if you want the reactivity, you still need, like you want to up, you have, you want a store like reactivity, you still have to do that. Yeah, so now I'm going to copy all this over here as well. I'm going to create a map value. So now I don't need this. I can directly use this map value over here. And do you notice that I do the export cons over here? So if I export things over here, this being exported like a module, right? This is module level. So I can import map value from this map.smelt. So previously I'm import this over here. Now I can write this like this. I can import map and map value. This is a module level export and get. If you use exports in the instance script tag, that could be a props or could be a component method. But if you have it over here, then you're able to import it in your module. So this is like a module level export. So you import like a module name exports from a module, right? So you do it over here. So one thing you can't do is export default over here. Because you already have export default, which is the component itself. So you can't export default in a module context. Hopefully that's reasonable. So we have everything copied from the two files, map store and map data, into our component as a module context. And let's try to see whether everything still works as previously, right? So the store still works as we said just now. And so here we see that we have a function called setCurrentMap. And actually it does not matter whether we define this function over here or actually in the script tag, the instance script tag. So you may ask like, okay, will this be creating an extra functions every time? Well, it depends. Svelte actually will do some optimization. So it will see that whether this function is actually updating something that is like a state, or it's not a state at all, right? So this is not a state. If you take a look at the code, you would probably realize that this is still at the module level, right? So it doesn't really matter whether you do it at over here or within an instance, right? But as soon as you try to set something like this, then that's a different story. You make it inside as like a states method, right? So here, since we can do it this way, we can update this current map like this, then we might as well not have this function at all. And in the sets me, we just directly sets, you know, our current map. So you can directly change variables inside the context, module context. You just can't assume that it's like a state, right? So every time when you what I mean is that if you try to say define maybe a variable like count over here, and I'm showing this count, right? You can see that it is 1 for now, but every time when you're trying to change it, on click count plus plus, you can't really expect it to change. It does not work this way. You have to think that all these variables are like variables that you are defined in external files, external modules. So when you have this, usually what you do is you make it the writable store, right? And you update the very value of the store using a dollar sign to reference it and to update it, right? So this will update all, and you can see that this shares across all instances. It's not a state of your component. So hopefully you get that right, and that's all for now. If you have any questions, feel free to comment down below, and as always, like my video and subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.